Before we get started, I want to open this video with a disclaimer in that this particular analysis will be slightly more different from my other videos, as it does deal with sensitive social topics such as hate crimes, religion, and bigotry. If these issues may be upsetting to you, feel free to stop the video and check out my other videos. Outside of that, I hope you enjoy the video. When you think of Final Fantasy, more than likely you think of either swords, magic, or protagonists with the good hair. Final Fantasy has been around since 1987 and is one of the best-selling video game franchises of all time, and although many of the games are known for their amazing characters, awesome music, and compelling stories, Final Fantasy has not ever been shy in addressing social topics of today's society, with one game in particular that focused on a few issues around its main storyline. Let's take a look at the message behind Final Fantasy X and how it addresses the issues of racism and religion. Final Fantasy X is about a young man named Tidus, who was a star of the fictional sport of blitzball until one night during a game, a monster known as Sin attacks his home of Xanarkin and transports Tidus to the world of Spira, where Sin also runs rampant. Tidus eventually meets Yuna, a summoner whose mission is to go on a pilgrimage to stop Sin with the help of Aeons and the final Aeon, which she will get in the ruins of Xanarkin, as this Xanarkin has been destroyed for 1,000 years. Tidus also meets her guardians Wakka, fellow blitzball player, Lulu, a stoic black mage, and Kamari, Yuna's guardian since she was a young girl. Tidus also runs into Orin, a friend of his father Jecht, who has since passed on and joined Braska, Yuna's father, 10 years ago to bring the calm, a period of peace which happens when Sin is defeated. Orin was also watching over Tidus at the request of Jecht and was present when Sin attacked Xanarkand. They also run into Yuna's last guardian, Riku, an Albed girl who is Yuna's cousin and who saved Tidus from the ruins of Botched Temple when he first landed in Spira. As the journey progresses on, Tidus learns more about the teachings of Yevon that also tie into the pilgrimages of summoners, and midway through the game, the group realizes that Yevon's teachings are hypocritical. For example, machina, or machines, are forbidden in most cases, especially as use of weaponry. But the Crusaders, volunteer warriors led by Wynn Keenock, who is a maester of Yevon, use the Machina weapons alongside the Albed, a tribe of technologists who use Machina generally oppose Yevon's teachings, in an effort to stop Sin. They find out the final summoning is a lie, as a guardian is chosen to become the final Aeon in a ritual that kills the summoner. Although this ritual destroys the current Sin, the chosen guardian goes on to be the next Sin, and the cycle continues, thus Spira lives up to its name, the Spiral of Death. On top of that, the maesters, or leaders of Yevon, are undead and use the teachings to wield power as they see fit, even though summoners are taught to send the bodies of those who died to the afterlife so they don't become fiends or monsters. Tidus also learns he is a dream of the faith. Faith are the souls of people who go under a ritual that remove their souls and seal their bodies in stone tablets. The faith lend their strength in the form of aeons to summoners. Tidus is from a dream Xanarkin, which was ordered into existence after the original Xanarkin was destroyed in a Machina war. The faith want Tidus to destroy Sin once and for all, but if he does so, the dreaming will end and Tidus and Jecht will cease from existence. Tidus initially keeps this from his companions, but reveals this after their final fight with Sin. Yuna and her guardians find a way inside Sin and destroy the current final Aeon, free the Aeons with Yuna, and destroy Yevon once and for all. The eternal calm is brought, and Spira is finally free from Sin's destruction once and for all. Before we can really dive fully into the religion of Yevon and why the teachings are so problematic, we first need to talk about a character who is deeply affected by the teachings from before Final Fantasy X and up until the end of the game, and that is our orange-haired friend Wakka. Wakka grew up on the island of Issei with his younger brother Chapu and fellow orphan Lulu. Their parents were killed by Sin, so Wakka raised Chapu as more of a parental figure than a brother. It was at this early age that Wakka became a devout Yevonite, believing if people stuck to the teachings of Yevon and atoned, their sins would be forgiven and Sin would disappear. By the age of 13, Wakka began playing for the local blitzball team, the Besaid Oryx, as his brother also started to learn blitzball. Around this time, Yuna was also brought to the Besaid Island by Kamari at the request of Orin, as Yuna's father just defeated Sin and ended his pilgrimage. This particular period of time takes place 10 years before Final Fantasy X and is the beginning of Braska's Calm. 9 years later, and 1 year before the events of Final Fantasy X, Luzu, a friend of Chapu's, convinces him to enlist with the Crusaders after declaring his love for Lulu, and was quoted in saying, "Being with your girl is good, but keeping Sin away from her is better." Wakka gifted Chapu the sword Brotherhood, but Chapu preferred fighting with an Albed Machina. Chapu died near Jose fighting Sin, and because of this, Wakka began to resent the Albed, as Yevonites usually view them as heretics because of their opposition to the Summoner's Pilgrimage. Wakka's prejudice of the Albed is first evidenced when Orin suggests to stop at Rin's travel agency, protesting that it's not only ran by an Albed who doesn't believe in Yevon, but also at the fact that they kidnapped Yuna during the Blitzball tournament in Lucca. Yuna and her guardians also witnessed Maester Seymour giving his blessing to the Crusaders in the upcoming Operation Meehan. However, Wakka is shocked by this because they are using Machina along with the Albed. When confronting Maester Seymour about it, Seymour responds with, although Machina is forbidden, both the Crusaders and Albed wish for peace for Spira and to pretend they didn't see Machina or hear Seymour say that. Luzu also confesses to Wakka not too long after that it was him who convinced him to join the Crusaders. This infuriates Wakka as he had no knowledge of this, however Lulu did, which furthers his hate for the Albed even more. While crossing the Moonflow, Wakka tells Tidus to look at the sunken city in the river below and begins to talk more about why Yevon has a problem with Machina. Wakka believes that the city was sunken below because they tried to defy the law of nature by building the city over the river. However, Tidus does not believe this is the case. Wakka states that Yevon has taught them that when people have too much power, they seek to use it, a line that later rings true in a different context. Yevon allows the use of Machina for entertainment purposes, such as the Blitzball Stadium and video and audio with spears, but forbids Machina use for weaponry. Lulu and Wakka also talk a little bit about Sin's origin. 1,000 years ago, the Machina War took place between Bavel and Zanarkin. Bavel used Machina so powerful that they almost destroyed the entire world. Yu Yevon, a summoner and leader of Zanarkin, turned the survivors into Faith to create Dream Zanarkin, and then went on to become the first incarnation of Sin, without an Aeon at its core. Sin would go on to destroy cities that relied too heavily on technology, or cities that grew too large, because of its memory of Bavel wielding Machina. After telling this story, Yuna is then kidnapped by a Machina and is saved by Wakka and Tidus. Wakka begins to theorize why Yuna was kidnapped again and begins to insult the Albed loudly, not knowing that Yuna herself is half Albed, as her father married an Albed woman. One of the biggest ironic moments is shortly after, Tidus is reunited with Riku, who reveals she was behind the Machina, and when the group discovers him, Tidus introduces her as the person who saved his life, almost giving away her Albed heritage. Riku's hidden Albed heritage does not last long, however, as while Yuna is about to be escorted by Tromel Guado to Makalania Temple, Riku's brother, who is literally named Brother, attacks the group with Machina to prevent her from reaching the temple. Riku converses with her brother after the battle, and Riku admits to Wakka she was an Albed. Wakka gets into an argument with Riku about the teachings of Yevon and about Albed being heathens for using Machina, and it goes around in circles as Wakka is steadfast, believing that as soon as people atone for their sins, sin will go away. While Riku says there may be another way instead of having to rely on summoners. Tidus protests that although Riku is Albed, he knows she is a good person, much like Orin when meeting Riku for the first time didn't care Riku was an Albed, as long as she was certain in protecting Yuna and as long as Yuna was okay with it. Matters are complicated even more when they realize the truth about Seymour in a spear dropped by Jisco Guado, the father of Seymour, trying to escape the far plane in Guado Salaam. 2 weeks before the events of Final Fantasy X, Seymour killed Jisco to succeed him as the Maester of Yevon. Although unsure of his plan, Jisco details in his spear that Seymour is using Yevon, the Guado, and the summoners for his own twisted plan and urges whoever's watching the spear to stop Seymour. Wakka is hesitant to fight Seymour, but Orin urges them as a guardian that will protect Yuna from anyone, even a Maester of Yevon. After Seymour is killed, Yuna and her group are branded traitors of Yevon, but Orin encourages Yuna to go on with her pilgrimage, stating that the Aeons give summoners the power to defeat Sin, not the temple or the teachings. Wakka is still very upset about what has happened and even wants to leave the pilgrimage, and he's even more upset when the group is transported to Beacon Isle Island, home of the Albed. Riku reveals that Yuna must be nearby and home, a secret place where the Albed gather, which is also unknown to the outside world as their last home was destroyed by Sin. When they reach home, it is under attack by Guado to wage war on the Albed. It is revealed that summoners were kidnapped by the Albed, were held in the Summoner Sanctum of Home for safety. The group are also introduced to Cid, Riku's father and Yuna's uncle, and the leader of the Albed. It is during this attack that Wakka's heart begins to soften for the Albed, as he tries to comfort Riku and curses the Guado for attacking the Albed for no reason, other than to try to kidnap Yuna for what they did to Seymour. Although Yuna was taken by the Guado before they reached the Sanctum, Riku also reveals that they know about this final summoning ritual, which everyone knew but Tidus, where the summoner dies when choosing a final Aeon, and don't want any more summoners to throw away their life for sin. After boarding the airship, Cid reveals they have to blow up home, and Wakka sheepishly tries to comfort Riku but fails in doing so. When they finally locate Yuna and Bavel, who plan on marrying Seymour in order to get him to turn himself in, as Seymour was not sent and is now undead since he is still attached to Spira, they attack the ceremony until they are forced to stand down. However, with the help of both Yuna and Riku, they get away and seek refuge in the temple, where they notice the temple is using Machina. It starts to really sink into Wakka that Yevon's teachings about Machina is hypocritical, and Wakka begins to slowly cast aside not only Yevon's teachings, but his racism towards the Albed as well. This is also seen in later cutscenes near the end of the game, where he makes his peace with Cid and Riku, as with the latter, they are on very friendly terms. As mentioned before, one of the components behind Wakka's beliefs and his prejudice towards the Albed are the hypocritical teachings of the religion of Yevon. We have to dig a little deeper behind the initial history of Yevon and its beginnings, and how and why it has a grip on spirit in the current timeline of Final Fantasy X. As mentioned before, 1,000 years ago, the Great Machinate War was fought between the cities of Xanarkand and Bavel, the latter of which used Machinate exclusively. The ruler of Xanarkand, Yu Yevon, who was also a summoner, realized not only that they were losing the war, but the chance of Xanarkand being erased by history forever. Yevon had the survivors become faith while he used pyreflies to create an armor known as Sin. Sin would attack any large and/or cities with advanced technology to keep people from reaching Dream Xanarkand out in the sea. As time passed on, Yu Yevon's humanity faded as the only thing left for him to do was to give in to the instincts of Sin to keep destroying large and technological cities and maintain Dream Xanarkand. Because of the first instinct, he destroyed the original Xanarkand as the people were now preserved in Dream Xanarkand. Lady Unaleska, Yu Yevon's daughter, devised a technique and ritual known as the Final Summoning to defeat Sin. The Final Aeon, an ultimate summon, is made when the person that the summoner chooses shares a deep bond with that person, a friend, a family member, or a lover, in Unaleska's case, her husband Lord Xeon. The Final Aeon is able to pierce the armor of Yu Yevon and destroy Sin, but after Sin is defeated, Yu Yevon then takes control of the Final Aeon and severs the bond between the Final Aeon and the summoner, killing the summoner in the process. Yu Yevon then uses this Aeon to rebuild Sin, but until that time comes, a period of peace without Sin known as the Calm is born. After Sin came back using Xion as the armor and ended the first Calm, Machina began to fall out of favor for use as Sin would destroy the Machina civilizations. It was at this point that the religion of Yevon was created based on practices that have seemed to work so far. The forbidden use of Machina that Sin would target, putting the faith in temples around spirits so that summoners can use them to defeat Sin, and the promise of Sin being vanquished with the final summoning. However, Yevon started preaching false information through this religion. For one, the idea that Sin would go away if people atoned for their mistakes. This had no effect as every Calm, Sin came back because only those who were in the know of the Yevon religion, more specifically the Maesters, knew that this was false but used it as a truth to give Spirit a hope. The other part of this is although Sin did hate Machina, the Albed were used as scapegoats because of the repeated use of Machina, and not to mention that they worked for the factories that produced the Machina for Bavel in the Machina War, and many were even hunted and executed as Yevon rose to power. To this day, the Albed are considered outcasts of society due to not only their use for Machina, but because they oppose the truth behind the final summoning. As we go back to the current day and events of Final Fantasy X, the teachings of Yevon are almost law around Spira. Yevonites oppose and almost suppress any kind of truth outside of the beliefs of Yevon, knowing full well that the teachings are a lie and to their knowledge that Sin is eternal. This becomes a shock for Yuna and her party, especially with how corrupt Yevon's maesters are, as seen with Yuna's trial. Although it is a summoner's duty to send the dead to the far plane so they can rest and not become fiends, Grandmaster Yomika, the current leader of Yevon, reveals that he is also an unsent. He reveals that Spira is exactly what's in the name, the spiral of death, and death is the only thing that is constant in Spira. The atonement won't stop and Sin cannot ever truly be defeated, and arguing that while summoners gave their lives to fight Sin, it's not ever in vain because Spira needs to relish in hope more so than despair. There is even a hint of racism in the upper ranks of Yevon. Although non-humans like Seymour Guado, who is half-human half-Guado, and Kelk Ronso were brought in as part of their initiative to unite the races of Spira, Micah laughs at the shock of Kelk towards Seymour murdering his father, saying, "Ever the Ronso, hard-headed and hardly useful." And as mentioned before, Yevon's teachings justify racism towards the Albed because of their use of Machina, which is ironic considering that the Albed see through the lies of Yevon and their constant need to throw the summoners at Sin to try to stop it. Yuna's defiance against the teachings grows even more when her group arrives in Xanarkand and learn the real truth about the final summoning from Unaleska. She also reveals that while the atonement of sins is hope for Spira, sin is never ending no matter what you do. Yuna then states that she chooses no guardian to be her Aeon and that the final summoning needs to be done away with, and they defeat and send Unaleska to the far plane. When they come back and reveal to Micah that they have finally destroyed Unaleska, Micah gives up all hope and cuts his tie to Spira, mentioning Yu Yevon's name before he goes. This is the clue that they need, as when they visit the Faith, they reveal that if they can fight Yu Yevon inside Sin and free the Aeons, Yu Yevon will be vulnerable and have no Aeon that it can emerge with, destroying Sin once and for all. As they succeed in doing so, the religion of Yevon is disbanded, as the truth is revealed behind its hypocritical nature. In my opinion, Final Fantasy X's core theme is what can be a problem with religion. As time passes, the original meaning and spirituality behind the message can get more diluted and stray away from its original message. Yevon was used to justify racism and prejudice, even though Bavel, the heart of Yevon's religion of Final Fantasy X, was responsible for starting the Machina War with Xanarkand and used Machina to nearly destroy everyone in that city. Because they thought they were better than the summoners, they were rewarded with the almost internal curse of Sin. Yevon's practice of thought suppression and near brainwashing of the masses is evident in the current timeline. The Maesters of Yevon also use their religion as law and power. Wakka quotes that the reason sin appeared is because when humans have power, they seek to use it. If you don't stop them, they go too far, yeah? Orin says something similar in the Guado Salam while waiting for Maester Seymour to appear. Those with power use that power. Maesters have power. Foreshadowing Seymour's plot by marrying Yuna, Ori's plot to merge with sin to wield ultimate power. If Yevon's core beliefs are to lie to the public about the truth behind sin, use people as scapegoats and justification for prejudice, then maybe Yevon isn't all what it's cracked up to be. Let me know what you guys think in the comments down below. What was your experience with Final Fantasy X? If you enjoyed the video, consider sharing it with your friends, giving it a like, commenting, and subscribing, as these all help with the YouTube algorithm and help the channel grow. Thanks for watching, stay beautiful, stay awesome, and we'll catch you around next time.